Hello and welcome to the session. Today I'll help you with the following question. The question says, express each number as a product of its prime factors. We know that every composite number can be expressed or factorized as the product of primes, and this factorization is unique apart from the order in which the prime factors occur. This is the key idea to be used for this question. Let's move on to the solution. The first number given to us is 140. Now we will express this number as product of its prime factors. The smallest prime factor of 140 is 2. So we divide 140 by 2, we get 70. Then 70 is divided by 2 again, we get 35. Now 35 is divisible by the prime factor 5. So when 35 divided by 5, we get 7. Then 7 is divided by 7, we get 1. So we get 140 is written as 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7. That is 2 square multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7. Next number that we have is 156. We will express this as product of its prime factors. Now again, smallest prime factor of 156 is 2. So we will divide this by 2. We get 78. Then again, 78 is divided by 2. We get 39. Now, 39 is divisible by the prime factor 3. So when divided by 3, we get 13. 13 is divided by 13. We get 1. Thus we have 156 can be written as 2 multiplied by 2 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 13. That is 156 is equal to 2 square multiplied by 3 multiplied by 13. Next we have 3825. We shall express this number also as product of its prime factors. Smallest prime factor of 3825 is 3. So we divide this by 3, we get 1275. 1275 when divided by 3 gives us 425. Then again 425 divided by 5 gives us 85. 85 divided by 5 gives us 17. Then 17 divided by 17 would give us 1. So we have 3825 can be written as 3 multiplied by 3 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 5 multiplied by 17. That is 3825 is equal to 3 square multiplied by 5 square multiplied by 17. This is the product of its prime factors. Next number given to us is 5005. This number is divisible by the prime factor 5. So when this divided by 5 gives us 1001. Now 1001 is divisible by 7. So when this is divided by 7, this would give us 143. Then again 143 is divisible by 11. So when divided by 11 gives us 13. 13 is divisible by 13 itself. So when divided by 13 gives us 1. Thus we have 500 can be expressed as 5 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 13. Last number given is 7429. 7429 is divisible by the prime factor 17. So when divided by 17 gives us 437. Then again 437 is divisible by 19. When divided by 19, this gives us 23. 23 is divisible by 23 itself to give us 1. So we get 7429 is written as 17 multiplied by 19 multiplied by 23, which is the product of its prime factors. Hence, this is the final answer. For the first part, it's 2 square multiplied by 5 multiplied by 7. For second part, it's 2 square multiplied by 3 multiplied by 13. For the third part, it's 3 square multiplied by 5 square multiplied by 17. For the fourth part, it's 5 multiplied by 7 multiplied by 11 multiplied by 13. And for the fifth part, it's 17 multiplied by 19 multiplied by 23. So hope you enjoyed the session. Have a good day.